What's some of the craziest experiences you've had in Kensington?
The one is I was really sick and I was walking behind the Rite Aid and the Wawa on Aramingo, and a white van side door popped open and a guy tried to grab me. But I was sick, so I kind of like squirmed like away, and you know, they drove off real quick. But and I've been pistol whipped, you know, I've been robbed, you know, but that's normal down there, you know, like that's the norm, and the cops really don't care, you know, which is a shame. But you know, that's just an everyday occurrence down there. Like this morning I found like 4 bullets like next to a car. You know?
Like
the casings.
Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
So what do you think can be done to help change your situation?
I need to help myself.
Okay.
You know, like I know like what to do to get clean. It's just getting clean. And like now with like the whole shrink epidemic, like that's like a completely different thing out there, you know? Like that sickness is no joke. And I'm just terrified to go through it, honestly. Cause subs don't work. Methadone really doesn't work, you know? And that sickness is something that you don't wish on your worst enemy.
Okay, so speaking of the sickness and the addiction and things like that, what would you like anybody to know about what you go through out here and what you're dealing with, you know, battling addiction? Like for those that don't know, like what you actually go through, because sometimes people, you know, might say, get a job, stop using drugs,
right,
get off the streets.
What
would you like for them to know, to understand what you're dealing with?
We're people too, and you know, we're just going through something that is hard to describe, that not a lot of people understand, you know? And the people that like do understand, sometimes they just forget where they came from, you know? But like, don't be judgmental, because you have no idea what other people go through.
Right. So
nobody wants, like, no one wants to stick a needle in their arm. Like, I didn't wake up one day and just be like, you know, I'm gonna go and get high. Like, no, there was like circumstances around it.
Right, and as we heard from your story, how your situation started, you know, that's a pretty, you know, rare and unfortunate situation, and you know, you didn't choose that. But however, I do these videos to enlighten people so that, you know, people can have an understanding of, you know, this is a battle, an actual
right.
battle, you know what I'm saying? Whether it's...
Like, you wouldn't make fun of somebody that has cancer, would you? You know what I mean? Like, it's an addiction, like, it's a disease. So, you know, just try to keep it, like, in your mind like that. Like, you know, there's something wrong with us. Like, we're sick.
Absolutely. And, what would you like anyone to know about Christine as a person?
I have no idea. I'm just a normal person, you know, like, people, like, look at me and they're like, you know, why are you out here, you know, you don't look like, you know, you should be down there and everything, and it's like, you know, I'm down there for a reason. It may not be a good reason, but it's a reason, you know? People need to stop being so judgmental. I don't know. This new mayor has a huge impact on what people are going through right now. But that's a different topic.
Right. Well, they're trying to do a cleanup, so hopefully
they
come with some alternatives. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay.
They should have thought about that before they did this cleanup.
Right.
Because where are you going to put these people? You know, you can't just, you know, make being homeless a crime and have all these people down there. You know, like the jails, can't throw everybody in jail. It's, you know, they need to rethink their whole cleanup situation. My opinion.
Got you. And what advice would you give to someone so they won't go through a situation like this?
Talk to someone. Don't let it, like, fester inside of you. That's my problem. I don't talk
to you. How do it feel to talk about it now? Like, to do this interview?
Crying, so.
Right. It's always, listen, you see my reactions. Like, I'm used to it because a lot of times, honestly, people do need to get it out. That's one of the things I've noticed from doing these. People want to, and you know they want to get it out. Sometimes it's necessary, you know what I'm saying, to let it out and to reflect on something that you may be able to change. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I appreciate the raw emotions. It shows the realness, but I also know where it's coming from.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I hope that it's a healing process. Like, it's soothing to actually talk about it and, you know, get it out. And to also, you know, give other people some understanding and insight.
But if I can help one person, you know, like,
that's all it's about.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to end it on that note. Thanks, Christine, for your time. Thanks for sharing your story. And I will be, you know, keeping up, and hopefully things get better.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.